Is that Astro alright?
Yeah.
Good move, kids.
That'll be alright.
Hey Daniel, I got some new pants.
Cool.
Today.
Well, they're just like black.
And I'm wearing tonight the Friday night pants.
Are they boxers?
But I bet
they get
started.
Take it back,
they'll turn into municipal pants.
Get going.
Possible, but am I just too late for the dawn?
Yeah. Are you going to be Indian?
No, I'm not Indian.
What?
I'm part of the Indian wave.
Alright, I'll withdraw to show the lowest position. Done it? Look up, say, hello, I'm Daniel.
Hello, I'm Daniel.
Go on.
Hello, I'm Jim.
Here's the way it carries in.
No, whenever.
And we're Bob's champions. Playing in the top.
It's only fairly recently people have sort of catch on to the vibe.
Yeah. Also, their style hasn't been around in the public eye for a long time. So they've developed it from an old style.
I mean, the music we make is, you know, it's about melodies and tunes. And although I suppose we're part of the, you know, whole alternative music scene. I mean, we've got a lot of passion for his music, but. I think the melody is the most important thing to us. We're not ashamed to sing a nice melody and use a simple chord progression. Some of the best music is just the simplest one. I'd like to think that we don't conform to any of the images that the magazines and mean, the people that write about music always want to put you into boxes and give you a tag like Britpop, grunge, whatever. And even the bands that are lumped together often don't have much in common. And I wouldn't like to be part of any of that. But I mean, I can understand why people do it. You know, everyone needs a starting point to relate one thing to another in anything.
I reckon.
I reckon.
I think we're sort of like a blend of different styles.
I mean, the input Jim has, you know, affects the way I write songs, and I don't know, maybe the way I write songs affects the way you write songs. I mean, the songs we write individually will never be quite as full as when they're sort of written together. I think writing together is more fun as well than writing a song and then getting someone else to do
it. Yeah, that's what I think, yeah.
I've started, is it?
Yes.
It's sort of like, it's like original, isn't it, really, isn't it? It does come
from
sort of acoustic.
You can't help it. Yeah, but you can't help the shapes. But I think, yeah, the fact that we play on acoustics is important. Because it's sort of a bit away from that rock and roll, image type thing. But you can't help be shaped by things that you listen to. I mean, subconsciously, I think that's altering music. But I mean, I think our influences are varied and wide enough to give us all the freedom we want.
They are influenced by the sort of like level of guitar playing, sort of like, remember, like you can sort of like put sort of little notes and strum. But like, if you want to sort of do sort of like using all your fingers, then that sort of like goes into different sort of like rhythms.
Well, yeah, you give yourself more arrangement control. Like we listen to, you know, a bit of everything, a bit of jazz, a bit of classical. You know, all the music that's sort of technically or academically or whatever advanced is very inspiring. I think recently. Brian Wilson's had a big effect on me, you know, with all the Beach Boys, all the harmonies and stuff. The harmonies have been very important to us, I think.
Phil Withers.
Go.
Phil Withers is my sort of like latest influence. I like to sort of write new songs which have been inspired from, you know, that sort of style. But most of the stuff's been original.
Start again, because I missed the beginning.
Is it rolling?
Oh, you don't have to play it.
Oh, yeah.
But you can.
I'll just say that our latest one is sort of like using B chord.
Right, well, stop. Start now.
Well, the latest one is sort of like using the E chord, but like it's sort of got an. Might be a bit out of tune, but it's sort of like E. And if you work around that, you can find new chords higher up. Well, I sort of like worked out the chords, and me and someone called John Hinchcliffe, we were sat in a barn called Cruxton Barn, and we had a bottle of whiskey, and we just like sat by the fire, and we thought, oh, let's take some lyrics to it, and we basically come up with the lyrics for the Bobby song. I like it.
Heartfelt.
Yeah. Single. Bobby song. It's taken from a Bobby in Scotland. Near Glencoe. Went up one evening with Marcus and Wayne. And we sort of like went up on our mountain bikes. Sort of got very drunk and on a bottle of whiskey and sort of like walked outside had a urinate and sort of like saw a moon and it was full. They were on this hill just above us, towering over the Bobby, and he goes, you know, if you can sing a song about this, then they're very good. Later on, about 6 months, I was in a barn called Crookston Barn, and with John Inchcliffe, with those lyrics that would go to it, and so we we had a bottle of whiskey then as well. Watching Clive.
I think the bottle of whiskey's have been a big influence.
Yeah. I reckon. Especially to that one, anyway. But other songs have been influenced by other things, haven't they? Daniel Storer. Like, a lot of songs that we play together.
What was inspired me? The song we recorded earlier, the What If Earth Was Satan's Desire, that's a lot influenced by Nietzsche. I read a book, Thus Spoke Zarathustra, and I don't know, it sort of gave me loads of ideas, and I pilfered some lyrics from that book, and it's all about, the title, What If Earth Was Satan's Desire, it's a thought I had that just basically on a metaphorical level, where the earth could be like the physical epitome, can I say that? I don't know, of hell, you know, all the physical torment and suffering and anguish, and I think to get a heaven and avoid going to hell, you should do it all while you're here, instead of waiting until you're dead. Something like that, and we've done everything before and we'll do everything again. And I'm inspired by it.
Stop for start, yeah. There it was.
Okay, turn around and start say your line.
Bob's Champions? Oh yeah, I like him.
Do you sound sincere?
What would you say now?
Now, I've forgotten what it is, tell me again. I think they're one of the most inspirational bands. I think they're one of the most inspirational bands of the 1990s.
It's called Daniel Getting Comfy. Ah! Whoa!
Don't focus still on your big toe.
Oh,
that raised.
on levitating, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Oh, natural. Watch out. Thank you. you're not going to bother saying out when you started?
Oh, sorry. Loads of close-ups of your nose.
That'd be good, but you could hear the sound of you kicking plates with your feet, which isn't particularly professional.
Jesus. You finished?
Jesus, you...
Bob's champions? Yeah. Oh yeah, I like him.
I think they're one of the most inspirational bands of the 1990s.
And we're Bob's Champions.
Bob's Champions, with an eclectic mesh of influences ranging from mid-60s Beach Boys to Neil Young's early acoustic material, have become the nation's favourites over the past few months. With singles such as James and Ben having cemented their popularity, the band talked to us about their unique blend of styles and their new single, The Bobby Song.
Yeah.
some weight, and he sort of like went upon a mountain bike, sort of got very drunk, and on a bottle of whiskey, and sort of like walked outside of it, had a urinate, and sort of like saw a moon, and it was full. They were on this hill, just above us, towering over the lobby. And he goes, you know, if you can sing a song about this, it's very good. Later on, about 6 months, I was in a bar called Brooklyn Bar, and with John Inchcliffe, we wrote lyrics that go to it, and so we had a bottle of whiskey then as well.
I think the bottle of whiskey's has been a big influence.
Yeah, I reckon. Especially to that one.
And Ben, What If Earth Was Satan's Desire, and the Bobby song will be available on the band's forthcoming self-titled album, Bob's Champions. See the music press for details.
We are the world. point and having point.